Welcome back to Vampire the Masquerade Bloodlines. Last time we were looking to get healed after tearing apart a hunter posing as a stripper. Graffiti means that you get eaten. I'm gonna clean this city up. Oh, you were good. I mean, you weren't great, but you definitely solved my damage and blood problem at the same time. Very nice. Now, to see Ms. Velvet. Get a little XP out of that.
Look who's back.
Velvet.
Please, call me Vivi.
Oh, okay. You told me to call you Velvet, though. About that hunter.
Mm-hmm.
The hunter's dead.
Hmm. If we'd never taken the paths we did in life, could we have grown fond of each other? A shame you had to take her life. But you've saved mine. And I won't forget that.
Okay. You Toreadors, I bet you think you're deep, huh? Oh, we're not that mean. There'll be others. You'll have to do the same.
Yes. I'm quite a compelling subject, I'm sure. Hopefully, though, I'll have some lovely young kindred by my side to protect me.
You are, and you will.
You're just saying what I want to hear. Don't stop.
Don't worry, I won't. I had a question. What's to do in Hollywood?
Mingle, sightsee, chat, and me, of course.
Another question? Tell me about yourself. That's not really an answer. So you're a stripper, huh? How did you become kindred?
I'm sorry. I'd rather revel in the present than dwell on the past.
Oh, okay. Another question. Forget it. I gotta go. Now I think we can get another quest from her.
Poor David Hatter.
Yeah, there we go. That the guy who created Cop Rock?
David Hatter's an aspiring screenwriter and hotel manager. He comes in more often than he would admit. Several years now.
Oh, well.
Poor dear just can't get a break. I overheard him talking about his new screenplay with one of my girls.
No,
it was
one
about
of these guys.
Secret societies and creatures that found themselves dealing with inner beasts and persecution by elder monsters. Sound reminiscent of something to you?
There's some great answers here. He's writing a movie about the Bush administration. A movie about the game industry. He stole my idea. Oh, he's writing about kindred.
Yes. The details of his story were too insightful to be coincidental. I think someone's working with David. A kindred who doesn't realize the consequences of their actions. Do you know what the penalty for revealing ourselves to kind is?
No Christmas bonus. Death.
Death. I'm afraid poor David's big break. The screenplay he's worked so hard on must be destroyed, and his less than silent partner must be executed. I know David too well. I'm very fond of David.
Did you have to smile when you say executed? You're asking me to destroy Hatter's screenplay?
I don't think Hatter knows his collaborator is kindred. You'll have to take David's screenplay, and somehow you'll have to coax the name of his source out of him. Once you found out who, kill the traitor. But do not touch David.
Okay. Sure thing. Sounds pretty serious. I'll straighten things out.
David works at the Lucky Star Motel. He's very passionate about his writing. He loves to talk about his craft. I'm sure he'll talk about his screenplay. It may take some persuasion to get him to give up his collaborator's name, however.
The thing that attracted me the most was the promise of murder.
After this is over, I promise you'll have my complete attention.
Unlikely. As soon as I'm done, I'll be back. Oh, you tease. You tease. But that's the Toreador for you. Yes. So, anyway, we're going to go to the Lucky Star, and then we're going to go hunt down this guy's source and stab him in the brain. Also, while we're at it, we will also wrap up the Carnival of Death quest, which we've been picking the clues together about over the course of this whole LP. What are we at, like 30 videos? Jeez, it's only taken us like, when we first get the quest, it's like the third video, so like 27. Hey, buddy.
Sorry, no vacancies.
You had her, the writer?
Writer's such a tarnished term, you know what I mean? It's like every other guy says he's a writer, right? Like, you write a letter, you're a writer. You know what? It's like, what I do, that's screenwriting. Like, I encapsulate the essence of excellent film in my scripts, all right? Like, I'm like a blacksmith with pens, all right? I'm a welder of montage.
This character is too well written to not be based on somebody. I'm getting a little bit of Quentin Tarantino, I'm getting a little bit of somebody the dialogue writers probably knew. It's probably a little self-referential, too. I heard you're working on a vampire script.
Me? I'm, like, looking to redefine the vampire movie, okay? Like, tons of people make vampire flicks, like popular characters, but me, I'm gonna be doing the real deal. Like, not only is it gonna be scary, but it's gonna be, like, it's gonna be believable.
So, Twilight? Do you have a copy of your script around here?
A good writer always does in this town. Hey, you in the business? Because, man, I got tons of ideas for movies. In fact, I should give you one of my completed screenplays. This one's still a work in progress.
I think writers are so cool. Could I borrow it?
Of course! I hope you find it a stimulating read.
Probably more stimulating than you. Thanks. Say, did you have any collaborators on this?
I really can't talk about it. He likes his privacy.
Tough luck. We can intimidate him. Don't you think he wants to be famous, too? I mean, who doesn't?
Okay. He's a guy. He calls himself Julius. He lives under the pier. In fact, I'm supposed to meet him tonight. We talk about vampire film ideas all the time. He's a weird guy, but really creative. You know, I love how his mind works.
Thanks. I'll be leaving now. Well, we could murder him, but she Velvet would be very upset. And I actually think that fails the quest for us. As long as we have the screenplay and we can destroy it, no big deal. We're also picking up a hefty sum of experience, aren't we? What are we at? 13. Well, that's nice. I like the sound of that. How about we spend it on Protean 3 sounds good. Plus 2 stamina. Not bad. Get a bonus to Bashing Soak. And then in the next level we get plus 4 Strength. And then finally War Form. Let's do it. And now,
where to?
We go to Santa Monica. Home again, jiggity jig. Not really, actually. Our haven is now in the Skyline Apartments downtown. But you know what I meant. We're close enough. Let's do this first. Hello, Brother Salvage. Let's head on in. Surely nothing dangerous will befall us. After all, it's just a creepy, abandoned, junkyard. Seems legit. Bunch of dogs out here. Let's go, whoa! Hey, it's that guy from the diner that we saw. And some planes. Get back here. Yeah. Why you gotta throw cars at me, bro? Why you mad, bro? Ow. Yeah. Get back here. Oh god, fire! Oh my god, fire! Oh my god! Well, wasn't expecting that. I mean, I know he throws fire, but I wasn't expecting to be immolated, so... Oh, come on. No, there's... No, I had to have... Oh, God. Hang on. Let's try this again. I had to do everything all over again. But now, we should be able to get through this. Just fine. I hope. I did save this time, so we won't have to go all the way back. Thank God. I'm just gonna sit here while you throw fire. Come on. Throw it. Throw it! I dare you! Yeah! That blows up. Should be a way through. Let's go this way. Okay. Let's try and save again with our not-so-quick save. Come on. Okay. And let's have a chat with this guy. What a jerk, hucking cars and lighting me on fire.
Back off, vampire! Stay the fuck back! I did nothing to you!
What's the matter? Afraid of a fair fight?
My work is done. I don't want to, but I'll fight you to the death.
Tell me, why did you do it?
Why? So you can pass judgment on me? So you can decide if those murderers deserve to be gutted? You'll never know how it feels, never!
I'm so sad. I'm angry. No, it's true. Try. Make me understand.
My family, my children were butchered by small-time criminals just looking to rob a house, steal a car, take whatever. No sense to any of it. No plan, no ransom. Just kill them because why? Because they were there in the way?
So killing people made you feel better?
Not one of them paid. My whole family dead, my life gone. I'm supposed to let that happen?
These murders are your revenge?
Revenge? Justice? Whatever you want to call it. All I thought about is taking these evil animals, ripping them to shreds and licking their blood from my claws.
You gave in to the beast inside of you.
At least I put it to use. How many vampires have used their abilities for a just cause? At least I did something!
Gangrel draw power from instinct, not the beast.
I'm supposed to owe allegiance to some vampire clan I know nothing about just because I was attacked? I was left for dead. Providence made me what I am. I'm doing what I was meant to do.
You don't get to pick and choose what you like about being a vampire.
I won't answer to anyone, and you'll never take me alive, vampire. No one will take from me again. No one! Either we go our separate ways here, or one of us dies.
Do you think your family would be proud of how you're acting?
No! Oh, God, no! No! It's got to stop! I can't live like this! You're right. Oh, God, you're right. I'll never do it again. I swear. Forgive me.
Well, of course you'll never do it again, because they're all dead. But, alright, go on. Get on with your own life. Now, we could have, of course, beaten the crap out of him. But, it's a little more interesting to play it that way. Be the peacekeeper. Besides, you know, it reflects that Reyna's learned a lot in her time at Vampire Community College about the nature of the beast and kindred politics. Character development for the win. Jumping on dumpsters, also for the win. Now we have to go see Julius, because he done been leaking secrets. Went the total opposite way for getting down to the beach. So that one's done. Right. I've got 5 XP. Not bad. But I need more. I'm jonesing hard, man. Let's go down to the beach. Because I'm going to go surfing. We will deal with Julius. Oh, how he will be dealt with. And getting some XP out of it is frankly more useful to us than an extra point of humanity at Humanity 10. We're like some kind of vampire saint who just murders people. That's funny to me.
What do you want?
Here we are on the lag beach. You, Julius?
No.
You talk too much, Julius.
Please, I didn't mean to understand what I am. I didn't know.
I'm sorry, but there are consequences for exposing us to mortals.
I'm so sorry. Please. I'll never do it again.
Julius, the punishment for talking is death.
No. Oh, God.
They are my rules, you understand?
Please. Find your heart. Please. Find your heart.
I'm sorry, Julius. I wish there was another way.
You could let me go. I promise. I would leave Los Angeles. I swear.
Yeah, I heard that before. I can't. I just can't. Forgive me, Julius.
Oh God. No.
We're all just pawns in a game without rules, Julius. I'll do this quick. I promise. Oh, this is a little sad. I didn't even put up a fight. And because he's a vampire, it's actually a little hard to smack him down. Humanity lost. That's new. We can get him to leave town, which... gives us humanity, I think. think there's a way to get some money out of him, too. But I think straight killing him nets us an extra experience point. Somehow. Could be wrong. In which case, me, personally, would feel a little bad about murdering Julius in the face like that. But, you know, survival of the fittest. It's the world of darkness, after all. Emotions are for the weak. And also vampires, apparently. Woo! I'm just skipping along, happy as a clam, after killing a man. Now let's go back to Hollywood. No, let's go downtown. Because if we visit our haven, we can get another quest. There's a couple more things we need to do in Hollywood before we go to the mansion, because I want to do them first, and I want to prolong having to deal with the sewers as long as possible. So, next time we will do those chores, and we will also pick up this other quest. That's it for this time. Hope you enjoyed. Catch you later.